be quite an outstanding match indeed. Scheduled as well on the 19th of October, 19th of November, rather, we'll be seeing the likes of Pat Patterson once again return to the Garden and forced, actually, to once again face the individual who is likely to take the Intercontinental Championship away from Mr. Pat Patterson, making reference to Ted DiBiase. From there, yet another return match we'll be seeing will be the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship. The newly crowned champions, Ivan Putski and Tito Santana, facing the Valiant Brothers in a return event. A very special attraction, a most unusual attraction being presented on the 19th of November. Captain Lou Albano puts on the tights and will attempt to prove that indeed he's a better individual than an individual, of course, he has coached and managed, and handsome Jimmy Valiant, the representative of the Valiant family on this occasion in Madison Square Garden. In the main event and waiting in the wings, Big Bob Duncum. Mr. Duncum, the number one contender, meeting Bob Backland for the World Wrestling Federation title. It's now our pleasure to bring on the champion of this moment, Bob Backland. First of all, Bob, I'd like to wish you congratulations indeed for your victory in Madison Square Garden recently, pinning your opponent 1-2-3. But Mr. Duncum, perhaps a horse of a different color, so to speak, in many, many respects. He's not only a big man, he's a man with tremendous agility. Every asset you can imagine is possessed by Big Bob Duncum.
Well, yes, he is, Vince. He's a tough man. I've watched a lot of films on him. He's very agile, and he knows his way around the ring very well, and he's got a lot of confidence in himself, and that's what you need to be a professional wrestler. You have to be a confident and know your abilities, and he certainly does have the ability, and he does have the past. He's been an athlete since he was 10 years old, probably younger than that, and competition has been maybe kicked into him and ground into him, but he's one of the toughest competitors, and I'm going to have my hands full, Vince, but I'm going to hope I can do my best and come out with a victory. I'm going to give it 100%. There's too many fans out there that have been helping me and getting me where I'm at, and I'm going to give it 100% for all of them.
Duncum, we've seen him do any number of holds. I might add to perfection, actually, and one of them is a bulldog, actually, where he just grinds his opponent's face, the neck area, right into the mat.
Yes, I've watched him do that to quite a different number of people, and once he does that to them, they're pretty much finished, Vince, and it does cause some injuries to the head, and it could possibly cause a concussion, and it could possibly retire you from wrestling, and even retire you from life, and I'm going to have to watch out for that very close, and I know that's what he wants to do with me, because that's how he wins his matches, but it's going to be interesting, Vince. I'm looking forward to it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bob Backlund. Our guest now coming into view, Captain Louis Albano. Mr. Albano.
Well, this can be a double celebration for the captain. As you know, the Valiant Brothers have chosen Jimmy to represent the team. They haven't been successful since they turned around and they claim dropped the captain, claiming I took too much money, claiming this, claiming I interfered. But let me tell you this, Vince McMahon. I made the Valiant Brothers. I can beat Jimmy. I can beat Johnny. I can beat Jerry. I can beat any combination, or I can beat all three, or that, for that matter, almost any of my men. Like Bobby Duncum is a different story. Bobby Duncum is a man that will listen to the captain. But let me tell you this, Valiant Brothers, I got a surprise in store for Jimmy. It will be downright humiliation to defeat and humiliate and humble Jimmy Valiant in Madison Square Garden. Now I want to talk about Bobby Duncum. I heard the champion come out here telling you about the bulldog, telling you that he's worried, telling you that there could be permanent injury to an opponent. Yes, this is true. And I've given Bobby Duncum, come over here, brother. Orders to listen to the captain. Tell him what you're going to do, brother.
Mr. Duncum?
Well, you know, Bob Backlund's up here. First thing I just got through learning about Bob Backlund, come up here and his voice is quivering just a little bit. That shows you that he's very insecure, very shy type person. He's really worried about the bulldog. Well, if I was him, I would really be worried about the bulldog, too, because many people have bit the dust from it. It's something that I perfected down south, and it's the old shot where you grind the head right through the mat. It's a little concussion thing sometimes it sets up, and it always knocks him out. And Backlund is supposed to be the heavyweight champion of the world. If he's so great, we'll see how he can take the bulldog, because he's going to go down. I'm going to be the next world champion.
Very confident, Big Bob Duncum.
Scheduled for one fall or two curfew. Here in the corner to my left, from Paulsboro, New Jersey, weighing 250 52 pounds, here is Pretty Boy Larry Sharp. And from Atlanta, Georgia, weighing 232 pounds, it is Dynamite Jack Evans. And from the Amazon regions of South America, weighing 260 pounds, it is the Golden Terror. And here in the corner to my right, from Pawhuska, Oklahoma, weighing 247 pounds, it is Chief J. Strongbow. And from the Isle of Samoa, weighing 275 pounds, it is High Chief Peter Maivia. And from Venice, Italy, weighing 256 pounds, Domenic Denucci.
Well, there we have the principals, and this should be quite an exciting match to watch. Here we go. Domenic backing Jack Evans into the corner. Golden Terra making a move over there as Evans turns Denucci right around. Headbutt by Denucci. So let's see what the pretty boy can do, Mr. Larry Sharp. Sharp on the receiving end of a right hand by Denucci, right in the nose. Whip to the rope, shoulder block. Off again comes Denucci, but this time Larry Sharp waits for him. Nice kick out by Denucci, up on his feet and ready to go. Denucci got him that time as well. Only in the forehead, the Golden Terra moves in. Strongbow's over there along with Denucci. And what has happened to the Golden Terra? And what is happening to everybody in there? Oh, the work. The Golden Terra trying to get his mask turned around, can't see a thing. And Maivia almost ripping it off. Meanwhile, the Blonde hit a lot of trouble as well. Sharp, Evans in the Terra, lacking somewhat in coordination here. The Golden Terra on his feet. Now we'll try to regroup. Somehow or another do a little better than they've shown us thus far. They haven't been able to muster much of an attack at all. Center up now, the Golden Terra. Denucci knocked down. The Golden Terra trying it again. Denucci lowering out shoulder. And the back body drop, reach up, tag made, and here comes Jack Evans again. Ooh. Denucci being choked by Evans, and Evans doing a pretty good job of keeping that choke hold away from referee Dick Worley. Worley breaks it up in any event. However, Worley does not see what's going on now. Triple team effort on Domenic Denucci. Past the crowd here, rooting for Denucci, Strongbow and Maivia. Whip to the buckle, coming out. Denucci able to tag. Here comes Maivia. And the rugged Samoan goes to work, cleaning house. The fans like what they see at the moment. Evans to the rope, off the rope, in the midsection, down on the canvas, and Evans will have a tummy ache later on. The Golden Sarah comes out swinging, however, at Maivia, beating him literally to the punch. Trying to get that mask off again. And look at Maivia. Handling him like you would handle a bull with one of those rings through his nose. The Terror flailing around, way now, trying to get his mask straightened out. Comes back to tag. It looks like neither one of these two individuals are too eager to step into the ring. Now it's going to be Jack Evans again. Oh, hot, brutal uppercut of Maivia. Maivia. One of the most rugged athletes, I think, in professional wrestling today. Maivia doesn't have a real scientific style, but he's one rugged man. He wins more than his share of matches. But right now, Maivia definitely in the wrong part of town. Triple team effort on Peter Maivia. Maivia now whips and ropes coming off. Oh, I pulled him over. Tag made. Here comes Denucci. Whips to the buckle, off the ropes, and the abdominal stretch. Will it surrender? Yes, sir. So, chug of a victory for Maivia, Domenic Denucci, and Indian J. Strongbow.
And the time, 6 minutes and 58 seconds. Here are the winners, Chief J. Strongbow, High Chief Peter Maivia, and Domenic Denucci.
Maivia, Strongbow, and Denucci victorious, and a happy threesome it is. Not so happy, of course, leaving the area now. Pretty Boy, Larry Sharp, Jack Evans, and, of course, the Golden Terror. And next week.
Santana join up. And their partner, Andre the Giant. The other side of the coin, so to speak, we'll see Jimmy, Johnny, and Jerry, the Valiant Brothers, team up with their manager, donning the tights, Captain Louis Albano. Yet another first in store for the fans this Monday night in Madison Square Garden, the presentation of an Indian strap match. Match in which both Jay Strongbow and his opposition, Greg Valentine, will be bound at opposite ends of the 12-foot leather strap. Bob Backlund is set to defend the World Wrestling Federation title in the main event against the title holder in his own right, victorious in his last outing, Pat Patterson. Speaking of Pat Patterson, let's bring on the North American heavyweight title holder now, along with his manager, the Grand Wizard of Wrestling. Mr. Patterson certainly hopeful and perhaps even confident of victory once again this Monday night in the Garden.
You know, over the years, Bob Backlund has beat a lot of wrestlers, a lot of great wrestlers. There's one man he can beat, it was Pat Patterson. I'll tell you, Backlund, I know that you're afraid to step in the ring with me again, but you're forced into it, and you're forced to face me again. You know what this means, Backlund? This means that I am now the North American champion, and when I get done with you, I will have not one but two championship belts, and you know it. I've said it before, and I'll say it again. I have a lot of patience. The timing is just right now. And I know you're afraid of me. Backlund, I'm taking the championship away from you. You know, you didn't look too much like a champion the last time. You were covered with blood. You didn't look like a champion. Who did that to you? I did that to you. You haven't seen nothing yet. It's only the beginning. And Backlund, I know you're running scared. And I'm telling you one thing. I'm taking the belt away from you, punk.
Pat Patterson. Our guest at this moment will be the individual who will oppose Greg Valentine. Let's bring on Chief J. Strongbow in the special Indian strap match for the first time ever being presented this Monday night. Perhaps this more than anything else, J. Strongbow's type of match. And Jay, the fans are hoping that you'll be victorious, unlike your previous encounter with Greg Valentine.
You know, Greg Valentine came out and told you something about he signed a blank contract. He was so excited that he got out of the ring alive that he'd just sign anything. The strap match is one thing. To keep him inside the ring, I have no advantage over him by having a strap match. You know, things were settled with a strap match years ago. Somebody's going to get hurt with the strap.
Chief J. Strongbow preparing for the Indian strap match that will be held this Monday night when once again he meets Greg Valentine.
How about that? With a 10-minute time limit here in the corner to my left from Johnny Rodz.
Unpredictable is right. One of the many facets of the rather complex personality of Johnny Rodz. Johnny Rodz against Jay Strongbow should be quite a match here to open up things, and we're set for the action to commence. Pausing for a commercial note, Asbury Park, New Jersey, the setting for championship wrestling on an upcoming Tuesday night. Tuesday night, the 7th day of August. Scheduled to appear on the wrestling event held in Asbury Park on the 7th of August will be none other than the Pride of Pawhuska, Oklahoma. Yes, returning its chief, Jay Strongbow. Jay Strongbow looking forward to appearing in Asbury Park, New Jersey. Joining on the card, Domenic, Denucci, and others as professional wrestling appears in Asbury Park. Again, the date Tuesday, the 7th of August. Rodz on top of Jay Strongbow, literally as well as figuratively, and Rodz really caught Strongbow off guard there, Bruno.
Yes, he did. He asked the referee to examine the knee, the brace on the knee, while the referee was doing that, and Strongbow had his leg up. Here comes Johnny, who will take advantage of any opportunity, and he's been on him ever since, but let's not count this sheep out, because it won't be long, and we'll see him in there.
Strongbow on the outside, battling Johnny Rodz. Strongbow on the apron now. A couple of chops to the forehead. Strongbow back to the ropes and ready to go. Again, Rodz catching Strongbow off guard, complaining to the referee, and then from there, Johnny attacking Jay Strongbow. Face first to the buckle goes Jay Strongbow. Strongbow retaliating in his own right in an aggressive fashion, I might add. Strongbow applying pressure to the wrist.
Johnny Rodz out the clinch fist. I'm sure that warning many times falls on deaf ears. Strongbow back to the ropes. I believe he's close to the rope. Johnny Rodz reversing things. How did he do that, Bruno?
Well, he just comes so often.
Rodz may have reversed the hold earlier, but he paid for it.
He sure did, because again, now Vince, note when the chief came off those ropes and he slid right underneath between Rodz's leg and shot out on the other side, got up quick. Believe me, that knee wasn't 100%, and there's no way in the world he could have done that, which is fantastic to see, of course, because the chief himself said that the knee is 100%. But I think that proved it right there, Vince. Maybe that he's got a tape so tight, precautionary reason, or because he's got some plan which he does not wish to disclose, but I do believe that his knee is in great, great shape.
Strongbow back to the corner again, as we have seen many times here throughout this match, and Johnny Rodz certainly wanted to take advantage of a situation of that nature. At the moment, Strongbow slumping down into the corner. Johnny Rodz going to work on the knee now. Johnny Rodz going to work on the leg there. It has a knee brace on it. Now, how much damage you'll be able to do to Jay Strongbow's leg certainly is a matter of contention, but with that brace, I'm sure it certainly helps the situation out immeasurably.
Yeah, because to me, as he himself says, it's in very good shape. Now he's got to take so well. He's got the steel brace there. And really, it's not that easy to bend it around or twist it the wrong direction, the wrong way, which would do you all the damage. So after he broke away from Rodz, he's showing no ill effects at all of what Rodz was doing to his knee.
Only one showing ill effects is Johnny Rodz, who had his head rammed into perhaps the steel portion of that brace. Therein, perhaps it's a bit of an offensive weapon, Bruno.
It can very well be used, and I'm sure that deep down in Jay Strongbow's heart, he's got plans for that brace.
Rodz now off the ropes, down across the back of Jay Strongbow. Johnny Rodz using the ropes, perhaps as no other professional wrestler does, but he was caught there. It's over. Strongbow caught Johnny Rodz in midair, I believe, Bruno, with a series of one tomahawk chop there to the throat, and it was all over.
Right.
Strongbow victorious, and it is certainly a pleasure to see Jay Strongbow back to par, back in his usual form. We shall return, ladies and gentlemen.
If not the most powerful man in professional wrestling today, Nikolai Volkoff.
McMahon, not if. It is, he is the most powerful man. You know, I noticed when this man was wrestling, Bruno Sammartino was sitting over there. And there, you know, Bruno Sammartino is one of the most vain men I've ever seen. This was a fellow that prided himself on being so strong. He was the world's strongest wrestler when he was world champion. He was this, he did that. He pressed 628 pounds. But then when he sees my champion here, Nikolai Volkoff, the strongest man in the world, he just cringes. He wants to hide underneath the table. Bruno Sammartino, you never seen the day. You never seen the day you were half as strong as this man. You know the trouble with these Italians? When they reach the age of 30, they keep eating all that spaghetti and drinking that lousy stinking wine that those Italians eat. And then they just grow old. They don't want to go to the gymnasium and work out no more. They've had that easy life. But I guarantee you, he could work out from now till doomsday, and he couldn't even become half as strong as one side of Nikolai Volkoff. And then, coming to this namby-pamby, this so-called world's heavyweight wrestling champion, and you know I use the term very loosely, I'm talking about Bobby Backland. Now here is a rum dumb dinger. This guy here, he don't know which end is up. That guy has been given victory after victory from the referees, not from his ability. The man has no ability. All he is a heavyweight in weight only and in size. But up here where it counts, he doesn't have it. And why doesn't he have it? Because he led by another idiot. Arnold Skolin. This guy here doesn't know enough to get in out of rain. When it rains, he walks down the street, and somebody says, you know,
right,
it's
Mr.
raining.
Blassie, we've heard your commentary. You've mentioned two individuals here in reference to Bruno Sammartino and, of course, in reference to Bob Backlund. Let's go to you, Nikolai Volkoff. How do you compare your strength with that of Bruno Sammartino?
Я понимаю, проводя каждый день две рези по-русски, я желаю поздравить сам русский и словенский народ. Мы смо земля največа на свету. Мы смо имали свои олимпийские чемпионы. Russian! Gold medal, Russian Olympic champion! Bruno Sammartino е маленький, итальянец. Он еде паста, фаршол, спагетти. Он ема великий стомак, има великий нос. Он агли.
You know, it so happens that I have two Bob Backlunds here and two Bruno Sammartinos. This is Bob Backlund and this is Bruno Sammartino. Now, the world's strongest man will show you what he's going to do when he gets Bob Backlund in the ring and when he gets Bruno Sammartino in the ring. He's going to squash him like a grape. The most powerful hands in the world.
Bruno Sammartino!
If I just hold one of these apples, these are very strong. Yes. I can't do much with them, obviously, but...
Bruno Sammartino and Bob Backlund.
That's impressive. There's no question about that. But
that's
the apples
right.
aren't fighting back. The apples
that's
aren't
right.
attempting to put it
well,
in any
Well, that's what Bruno
on.
Sammartino and Bob Backlund going to be doing when Nikolai Volkoff puts the pressure on them. They won't be fighting back because they don't have the ability. As I said before, these are two of the most vain people I've ever seen in my life. Bob Backlund and Bruno Sammartino, both of them are a classic case of a thyroid deficiency. Their arms grew, their body grew, their muscles grew, but up here where it counts, that did not grow. Here's a man that I've taken, and I've nurtured, and I've maintained, and I've trained, and I've taught him all the finer points of wrestling, which means I've taught him all the illegal tactics. And I guarantee you, before our campaign is over here on the East Coast, this man will destroy Bruno Sammartino and Bob Backlund.
Him with his cane and Volkoff, they attacked me. Okay, they completely embarrassed me on television. There is going to be no feats of strength this time because all I want is I want to attack this man. He had the chance to prove his strength against me, and instead, he did what he did. Well, in the garden, there's going to be no feats of strength because from the time the bell rings or before, if the opportunity presents itself, I'm going to come after this guy. I'm going to attack him. I'm going to come up with everything that I have, and I'm going to throw it at him because I'm not interested in strength. All I'm interested is in one thing, and that is to destroy Nikolai Volkoff and to make him regret. And for the rest of his life, he's got to, no matter where he goes, he's got to realize that the biggest mistake he ever did in his life was to humiliate Sammartino on TV.
Thank you very much, Bruno Sammartino.
India weighing 265 pounds is Jojo Andrews. And his opponent from Krakow, Poland, weighing 230 pounds, Horace Powell. As well, ladies and gentlemen, he said it is the Polish power, Ivan Putski.
Ivan Putski really put together here against Big Jojo Andrews. We're set for the action to begin.
Pausing for this commercial note. Four of the outstanding Mighty Midget wrestlers appear on the Wrestling Spectacular headed to Madison Square Garden on Monday night, the 27th of August. The midgets on the card, along with Jay Strongbow meeting Dick the Bulldog Brower. The Great Hussein meets Tito Santana. Greg Valentine squares off against Steve Travis. The Valiant Brothers meet individual competition, all three. John Valiant against Domenic Denucci. Jerry Valiant faces Ted DiBiase. Jimmy Valiant, he meets Andre the Giant. Nikolai Volkoff meets the legend Bruno Sammartino. And Pat Patterson once again wrestles for the World Wrestling Federation title against Bob Backlund.
Ivan.